Hello CIS scholars, how are you all? I hope you all are enjoying a lot. Because why? Because festive seasons are going on, right? Independence Day, Janmashtami, and now this rainy season. Rainy season is also not less than festival, right? No? Okay scholars, so today we are going to continue our chapter 5 nouns. In chapter 5 nouns we already finished common noun, proper noun, and today we are going to do countable nouns, uncountable nouns. Okay, so let's start. Yes scholars, we will start today countable noun. What are countable noun? Countable noun is the name of anything that can be counted. Very easy it is, as you all know that the things which we can count, the name of that things can be called as countable noun, right? Like if I have a rubber band, I can count my rubber bands. If I have compass box, I can count my compass box, right? That I have 4 or 5, or my friend is having 3 or 2 less than me. So it means I can count. So compass box is a countable noun, right? In the same way, we will see some examples. Books, cats, fingers, birds, all these are the example of countable nouns. Means we can count all these things. Books we can count. If I have 4 or 5 books, which out of 4 or 5 I have to keep 2 or 3 books in my bag while arranging my bag. Okay, it means I can count my books. Cats, I have 1 cat as a pet, I can count my cats, right? Fingers, I have 5 fingers in my hand. Like this we can count. If we can count, it means it's a countable noun. In sentence we will see one example. Each hand has 5 fingers, right? Our each hand has 5 fingers, so total we have 10 fingers. Here 5 in one hand and in another hand again 5, it means we have 10 fingers. Means we can count fingers. So fingers can be called as countable noun, right? Okay, let's see another example. I have 10 pencils. 10 pencils means I can count pencil. It can be less, it can be more, right? But now I have 10 pencils. Means pencil is also a countable noun because I can count it. Okay scholars, so the thing which we can count can be called as countable noun. Okay, let's see uncountable noun. What is uncountable noun? An uncountable noun is the name of something that cannot be counted. Just opposite of countable, right? That too you all know very well that if we are putting prefix, then the word changes its meaning and it comes as a opposite of the previous word. So earlier we did countable, now we added prefix u and un. So it became uncountable noun. So meaning of this will change, totally opposite. So the thing or anything which we cannot count will come as a uncountable noun, right? Let's see example. Like sugar, sea, skin. Just 2-3 examples I am giving, but there are many things which we cannot count, like stars, right? We cannot count stars, the best example which we cannot count. So that can also be called as uncountable noun, right? Okay, let's see one example in sentence. A lot of sugar fell on the ground. How much sugar? That we don't know because we cannot count it. But to tell anyone, how to say a lot of sugar, bahut sara. But in that bahut sara, a lot of, we cannot count how much, 1 sugar, 2 sugar, 3 sugar, like that we cannot count. Yes, we cannot count, I am saying, but we can measure that, right? 1 kg, 2 kg, 500 gram, like that we can measure. But here we are talking about countings. Countings and measurement are two different things, right? So here we are talking about counting or not, uncountable, countable or uncountable. So sugar we cannot count, right? Let's see another example. I drank some milk before going to school. I drank milk. How much milk? I can say one glass of milk or some milk, but I cannot count it that I drank one milk. We are not saying like this, na? I drank one milk. No, we can say I drank one glass of milk. We can say I drank one glass of water. Glass, that is a tumbler through which we can measure liquids, but we cannot count liquids, right? So I drank some milk before going to school. Clear, scholars? Yes, I hope it's clear, because this you are learning since childhood, countable and uncountable things. Yes. Now we will do one exercise related to countable and uncountable nouns, right? Here what you have to do, given below are some words, put them in the appropriate boxes. Some words are given, group of words are there, and what you have to do, you have to put some words from that group to countable nouns if they are countable, and some or few in uncountable nouns if they are uncountable, right? So first we will see rice. Rice is countable or uncountable? Rice is uncountable, right? Hands, we can count if I have two hands, right? So I can count my hands. Some people are, because of any accident or because of any disease, if they are having one hand, so we can count their hand that they have only one hand, or if they are not having any hand, so it means we can count their hands. We can count our hands. So hands will come in countable nouns, and rice, we cannot count rice, just like sugar. I told you in example, right? Sugar example. So in the same way, rice can also be, can't be countable. So it can come in uncountable nouns, right? Next is letters. Letters can be counted. There are total how many letters in English? We can count. There are total how many letters in Hindi that we can count, right? So letters can be countable. Then next is words that you have to do by yourself. Ants, you have to do by yourself. The rest all you have to do by yourself. Milk can be uncountable because I told you in example, same, right? So what you have to do now, rest of the example, group of words, what are the words given here, rest of the words you have to put in the column whether they are countable or uncountable. Try to do by yourself, it's a fun. Yes, scholars. Now concrete noun. We will do now concrete noun. What is concrete noun? A concrete noun is one which can be felt, seen, touched or tasted. Means if anything is there and if I can see that thing, if I can touch that thing, if I can feel that things, then it means they are concrete noun, right? Concrete noun means to touch, to feel, to see or to taste. For example, table. All furnitures we can touch, we can see, we can feel. If suppose that current is not there, it's dark, but by touching I can feel that, yes? By shape and size I can feel that yes, it's a dressing table or it's dining table. By touching and by feeling I can realize that yes, this is this thing. Okay, so the things which we can see, which we can feel, which we can touch can be called as concrete noun. Here example, table, boy, cotton, right? Let's see example in a sentence. We bought a new dining table. What we bought? We bought a new dining table. So table, dining table can be seen by me, by others. Dining table can be touched by everyone. Dining table can be feel by anyone, right? So it's not essential to be all qualities to be there, but any one quality, if it is there, then we can say that it's a concrete noun, right? Let's see another example. Cotton fiber is obtained from plants. From where we can get cotton fiber? We can get cotton fiber from plants, but we can touch cotton, right? We can feel cotton, it's very soft like, right? and we can see it's very beautiful when it's looking pure white type. So we can touch it, we can see it. So it can come in concrete noun. So what you have to remember here, that concrete noun is noun which can be felt, seen, touched or tasted. Okay scholars, in your textbook nothing is given, means not a single exercise is given related to concrete noun. Okay, we will do the rest of the things in next video. Till that time, take care. Bye bye.